We are gathered together today in the face of these friends to join these two people in marriage, which is an honorable estate ordained for the mutual society, help, and comfort that one has for the other, both in prosperity and adversity, into which estate these two persons present come now to be joined. Daniel, will you take this woman to be your lawfully wedded wife to live together in marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor, and keep her in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, keeping only unto her, so long as you both shall live?
I do.
And Allison, will you have this man to be your lawfully wedded husband to live together in marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor, and keep him in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, keeping only unto him, so long as you both shall live?
I do.
Having agreed to this marriage, you will now give your vows to one another. So Daniel, you're going to repeat after me, and I'll break it down for you.
Okay.
I, Daniel, take you, Allison, to be my wedded wife.
I, Daniel, take you, Allison, to be my lawfully wedded wife.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
Love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
All right, Allison, now it's your turn, so I will do the same for you. I, Allison, take you, Daniel, to be my wedded husband.
I, Allison, take you, Daniel, to be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
Now that you've given your vows to one another, you're going to exchange rings. So whoever has Allison's ring is going to hand it to Daniel.
And yep, Daniel. Read it backwards.
Okay, let's do this.
All right. So
I give you this ring as a symbol of my love.
My faith and our strength together.
My faith and our strength together.
And my promise to learn and grow with you.
And my promise to learn and grow.
For as much as Daniel and Allison have consented together in wedlock, have witnessed the same before this company, have given and promised their vows to one another, and declared the same by the giving and receiving of rings, by the power vested in me by the state of Montana, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss your bride.
Yay! Woo!
I first met Dan, we met at Walmart, where we just met, which is a perfect place, yeah. And we were looking through all of the, these cases of CDs, and I was working there at the time. They're 80s love songs, pop CDs, and Dan had this kind of infatuation with 80s love music. I suggested a CD to him, and when he left, I ran out and just to talk, hear more about his taste in music.
He came running after me as I was leaving the store. Yeah. He thought I was shoplifting.
I didn't
like chasing me down in the parking lot.
He ran
up to me and said, "What's the funniest thing you've ever seen?"
Oh yeah, yeah. What was the funniest thing you ever seen?
No, I'll tell you later.
Okay, this sounds like a good moment. Dependable and mild. And trustworthy. And one time Dan came to Chicago. I met him on the Greyhound. He was on the Greyhound, and not the safest part of town. And he had these alligator skin suitcases, which seemed like actually something Master P might have out of a limo to a motel, but not necessarily to walk across the city. They're pretty stuffed. Had a lot of stuff in there. And like always, when we started talking, you're always so easy to pick up where we left off, even though a lot has happened over the years where we're in different places. We walked most of the way to my house in Chicago, and Dan said he was gonna stay for about a month. And I was like, oh, that's a long time. Like, I can't even barely survive right now. And I need to buy a tooth, you know, and I'm not making enough money. I'm just kidding. And so it'd be tricky. But I got sick. I got really sick, like the sickest I'd ever been, just immediately. And Dan did stay for a month while I was sick. And every night, Dan was there wearing this do-rag, you know, around his face.
It was a scarf.
To prevent himself from getting sick. in the room I was in.
Right.
In the
I was wearing masks the entire time.
It was
this was before COVID.
Yeah, so. It was pre-COVID, and you already were right.
Ahead of the curve.
Yep, right ahead of the curve. And we watched Seinfeld each night while I was so sick. And he stayed for the whole month. But there's nobody I'd rather be sick around, you know? I mean, well, there might be like a few models and like magazines or something like that, but no, I'm just kidding. That'd probably be terrible. But no, it was really great. It was a really great time. It's memorable time. And you're so thrifty and adaptable, you know, that you were just eating oatmeal the whole time.
Right. Made
it
much.
Really cheap and easy. I'll get closer. And although Dan,
scoot this way just a little bit. All right, ready? 1, 2, 3, big smiles. All right, you gotta kiss your bride in there, so that we know that this is your wedding. All right. Do some
please.
All right, ready? 1, 2, 3, big smiles. And kiss your bride again. There you go. Perfect. So,
right, okay.
You can do it next week too, but I would recommend you do it today so you don't
okay.
forget.
Okay.
Because it won't be completely legal until you get it recorded.
Got it. Okay.
That's the important part. All right.
Thank you, Judge Harrington. Happy Friday.
Thank you.
Go celebrate.
Yeah.